Hello students, I'm your mentor Shivani Sharma from mentorbuddy.com and I would like to welcome all of you in my next video on verbal ability. So students, in this video today we are going to have a look at the questions related with one word substitution section of vocabulary. We have seen that in vocabulary sections in competitive examinations, there is a type of question which deals with one word substitution. And how we are going to solve this question, we are going to see in the video today. So basically, if we focus on these questions, we will find that it is basically learning which is going to facilitate in answering these kind of questions. So given below is a table of commonly used one word substitutions. It will be helpful to you if you learn as many of these as possible, right? So remember, there's no shortcut to it. You have to learn all these words if you really want to score good marks in this section, right? So the table shows on the left hand side the words are given and the right hand side the meaning of these words. Like the first word says misogynist. Misogynist is referred to a person who hates women. Then we have numismatic. Now numismatic deals with coins. As we know, numismatist means the study of coins. So numismatic refers to somebody who collects coins. Then we have pacifist. Pacifist is a believer in the abolition of war. Right, so somebody who is not in favor of war, somebody who believes in the abolition of war is pacifist. Then we have pragmatist. Pragmatist is one who uses common sense. Then spendthrift, which is antonym of miser. So spendthrift means one who spends too much, right? So students, in these kind of questions, generally you will find the meaning is given as the question and you have to identify from the options that what is the correct one word substitution for the given meaning, right? So let us have a look at few more words related with one word substitution in next slide. So the table here is also having few words. Let us have a look. The first one says teetotaler. Now teetotaler means one who does not consume alcohol, right? So that person is referred to as a teetotaler. It is used as an adjective with the names of the people, right? Then unanimous. Unanimous means having the same opinion, right? Let's say, for example, there are 10 members in the group and everybody is suggesting person A to be the leader. Then person A would be the unanimous leader of the group because everybody is having the same opinion. Then we have the next word as horticulture. Horticulture refers to the art of garden cultivation. Then we have a hierarchy. Hierarchy means a system of persons or things passed on to one another. Then we have esoteric, which means known only by a few. Then we have bibliophile. Now here, as you can see, the root word is biblio and we all know that biblio is related with books because we have written bibliography after our projects, isn't it? I'm sure most of you are aware of this. So taken from the root word, even if you sometimes you don't know the exact meaning, you can get a good idea from the root word. So bibliophile means lover of books, somebody who has a love of books. Then we have dilettante. That is lover of fine arts. Then we have atheist. Atheist is one who does not believe in God. Then we have apostasy, one who renounces his faith or religion, right? That is apostasy. Then we have botanist. We all know botany is study of plants. So one who studies plants is a botanist. Then we have invincible. Invincible means one that cannot be defeated or conquered, right? So that is an invincible ruler or king. So students, like this you'll find in any good English grammar book a list of one word substitutions which are generally a part of vocabulary, right? You have to learn as many words as possible related with one word substitution, and I'm sure the words which I have discussed with you right now, they're really going to be very, very helpful for you. So thank you so much for watching this video and stay tuned for more videos like this on verbal ability. Thank you.